really gross weather today, though.
Oh, that's why. No, no thanks.
It didn't start off that way, though. It was decent. Eric took this beautiful picture up in Port Washington. Maybe it was a sign of things to come. Eric, I'm going to blame you on this one. No, look at the sun reflecting in this icicle or in this little chunk of ice on the ground there. Just a gorgeous start to the morning in Port, and it's not so nice outside right now. Winter weather advisory has been issued and it's in effect until midnight from Milwaukee County up to the north. That is mainly for freezing rain, generally less than a tenth of an inch, but a little bit of freezing rain can do a lot of problems on the roadways. Everywhere you see in pink is getting some reports of some of that freezing rain, some of that icing over. Showed you a picture earlier from Econimwalk from Cat showing some of that ice on the trees, also coating some power lines. Don't be surprised to see a bunch of little branches in the back of your yard because it's also windy on top of all of this. Temperatures right now, though, in the city from Milwaukee southward, all above the freezing, not quite close to that, flirting with the freezing mark. So that's why we're seeing all rain from Milwaukee down through Kenosha. Ken and Racine picking up over half an inch of rain already so far and down to the south. Yes, there's a whole lot more moisture to come. Sunset has set. 5:51 was the sunset. That's the last time we're going to see a sunset during the 5 o'clock hour until October 21st. Daylight saving time begins tomorrow. And well, it's going to look a lot nicer throughout the day tomorrow. May not feel, it's going to feel a little bit better than today, I think. 34 right now in Milwaukee. There's that easterly wind. It will still be breezy tonight and into the day tomorrow, but the visibility certainly will improve for your Sunday. Right now, visibility not so great. Below a mile at the moment in Milwaukee, 3 miles in Sheboygan, 2.5 miles in Port Washington, less than 2 miles in Waukesha, Racine, Kenosha, down through Whitewater as well. So at times, the rain or freezing rain may be coming down a little bit heavy or even getting a little sleet mixing in there up near Plymouth, all from a huge storm system that is bringing some severe weather down to the south. Places they saw it last week are getting hit again with that tornado watch. For us, we're on the colder side of it. Winter storm warning, though, 8 to 12 inches of snow expected in parts of Minnesota. For us, again, that winter weather advisory is mainly for freezing rain. We will see a little bit of snow as temperatures start to fall a little bit as we go into the overnight hours. So again, watching that rain transition to some very light snow. Most of this is done by about midnight. Then heading into tomorrow morning, there might be a couple flakes still lingering in the morning hours, especially up to the north and to the west. But look at the winds. Those are those winds from the west tomorrow. Different story. That's going to clear out the clouds tomorrow. It will still be windy throughout your Sunday. Temperatures are going to be in the 30s, so a little bit more of a raw day ahead. Getting into your Monday, though, lots of sunshine expected. The wind's going to start to calm down, and then temperatures eventually are going to be increasing throughout your 7-day forecast. For the rest of the evening, though, still monitoring that chance for some icing. Again, generally less than a tenth of an inch. This could still cause some problems, especially on untreated surfaces, bridges, overpasses. Those are going to be some your problem areas throughout the rest of the evening, so take it easy on the roads. How much extra rain are we talking from Milwaukee southward? About a third of an inch. Most of this, again, wrapping up by about midnight. On the backside, I think these snow totals are a little bit too high, but generally we could see 1 to 2 inches of light snow north of Milwaukee. For us, though, here in Milwaukee, watching that rain change over to some very light snow, temperatures hovering just above the freezing mark. It will be windy as we spring forward tomorrow, so don't forget to change your car clock either. 37 then for a high on your Sunday. Again, a few flurries early. Skies will slowly be clearing out, and we'll get rid of some of that cloud cover by the end of the day. We will not get rid of the wind, though. It's going to be a breezy Sunday. Still breezy on your Monday, but a lot more sunshine. Temperatures just above the freezing mark for Monday. Get into Tuesday, though. Increasing clouds, increasing temperatures as well, up to 42. 50s for your Wednesday and Thursday. Don't get too excited about that, though. It comes with a chance of some rain showers, and it's not going to stick around for too much longer. Still a lot better than what we were talking last week.
Yeah, I'm okay with that. All right. Thanks, Jesse. Yeah.